Welcome to iClicker Cloud, the instructor platform that makes it easy to run polling sessions, manage grades, and track student attendance. This video will show you how to set up your course for attendance, run an attendance session, and manage the attendance data after class. Before we get started, make sure you've already set up a free iClicker Cloud instructor account and created a course. Let's get started. In your iClicker Cloud course, you might be tempted to click the Start Attendance or Start Class button. But hold on, let's customize your attendance settings first so things can run smoothly for you throughout the term. Click Settings. In the Course Details tab, make sure you've made an accurate selection under the Course Activities section. If you're only using iClicker for attendance and not for polling and quizzing, Attendance Only should be selected here. Next, navigate to the Attendance tab. The system default is for iClicker to take attendance whenever you start a session. If you're using polling or quizzing, you'll see this option to turn off attendance altogether. But if you want to continue setting up and running attendance, just keep it switched on. If you're setting up an attendance-only course, this option won't be here. Now let's talk about your options for customizing attendance for your course. First, alerts. If you'd like to highlight students who might be at risk for missing a certain number of classes, you can set that up here. Next, auto run. This is where you can choose whether or not you'd like an attendance session to start automatically during your class days, rather than you manually opening one up when you get to your classroom. In order for this to work, make sure you've entered accurate meeting times in the course details section of your settings. Some instructors like to open up attendance maybe 5 to 10 minutes early, so students can check in and be ready to go when class starts. Finally, there's location. The default setting is not to require location. This means that students could check into your class from anywhere. But if you do choose to require location, students can only check into your attendance sessions if they're physically in your class. In order for this to work, you need to pinpoint the location of your class. Select Require and Set Location for Attendance. This will open up a Google Maps window. Your browser might approximate your location, indicated by the blue dot, but you can manually select the location of your class by typing the address into the search bar as well. Either way, you can adjust your location if needed. Simply click and drag the blue dot. Next, choose a location radius from the drop-down menu to define the range that your students must be in to check into your class. Now your class location is set up. Remember, this location setting is totally optional and only applies to students using iClicker Reef to participate. If you'll also be running polling or quizzing sessions and have students participating with an iClicker remote, this location setting doesn't actually apply for them. Instead, you'll want to visit the Clickers tab. Then check this box to enable Clicker students to be marked as present when they respond to a poll or quiz question while attendance is running. All right, you're almost ready to run attendance. Just click Save when you're done and return to the main screen for your course. Now for the fun part. It's the start of class and you're ready for students to check in. You can manually start your attendance session by clicking this button. Then you'll see the Active Class Session panel appear on the right-hand side of your web browser. If you set up Auto Run, this would already be open when you sign into your course. This panel shows you how long your session has been open, as well as a summary of student check-in statuses. Now that your session is open, students in iClicker Reef will see a banner on their device letting them know it's time to join. When they successfully check in, you'll see that information updated in the Checked In section in the panel. You can also see a list of students who haven't checked in yet. If you've turned on the location requirement and need to temporarily disable it, you can do so by clicking this toggle. This is a helpful option if you need to accommodate any students who are having technical difficulties with their geolocation settings in class. If you haven't required location for your attendance sessions, you won't see this location information in the panel. An attendance session will run in the background until it's ended, even if a polling or quizzing session is open. It can end in two different ways. If you've chosen for attendance to auto-run during class, it will just end at the time that you specified in your settings. But you can always choose to manually end a session, even if you have auto-run in place. Just click the End button in the panel. Once you've run some attendance sessions, you can view all of that data in the Attendance tab. This is where you can see the attendance records for all the students in your course. If you ever need to update the attendance status for a student individually, simply click on the cell and change the status. If you need to include a note, you can do that as well. Then click Save. Now you'll see a gray triangle in the corner of that cell, indicating that you've manually changed it. If for some reason you need to delete a session altogether, simply click the session name, then choose to delete it. Finally, if you want to download any of this data into a spreadsheet, just click Export. Then select some or all of the sessions to download. Want to learn more about what you can do in your iClicker Cloud course? Visit iClicker.com/support.